Fatigue is a potentially very big problem in aviation. Aviation is a 24-hour operation. We fly at night time, back of the clock, across multiple time zones. The fact that the sun's not up doesn't mean we can't fly. So when people are operating aircraft, maintaining aircraft or controlling aircraft at night or extended periods of time, fatigue, if it occurs to them, can obviously lead them to potentially make errors, which can be significant.
Previously, fatigue tended to be an industrial issue with management on one side wanting maximum productivity from their employees and employees on the other side pulling on the tug of war looking for better conditions of work. But science really comes in the middle and tries to make sure that we're looking at an objective approach to fatigue, looking at it from a safety perspective rather than an industrial one, and making sure that we've got, as I said earlier, a shared responsibility between both the organisation and the employees to get a better outcome.
One of the big factors that to me is low-hanging fruit for our LAMEs is shift work, and just giving some thought on the impact of shift work over the longer term. It's what we call circadian desynchronisation. So what's that mean to most of us? Most of us like to go to bed probably around 10, 11 o'clock at night and get up around when the sun comes up. And that's a circadian cycle that we go through on a daily basis. Any personnel exposed longer term to having to move their bodies from being, you know, sleeping during the night to then have to work night shift and repeatedly changing is basically putting their body outside of what is a normal synchronisation. We know for a fact, and this is in consultation recently with NASA and a number of other research reports, there's almost a 40% increase in cardiovascular disease for people that are exposed to those shift changes that lead to that longer term patterns of desynchronisation. Biggest area for maintainers to be and LAMEs to be careful of when it comes to doing tasks is your actual motor skills to do repetitive skills based, pick up a spanner, turn it, tighten it to a specific setting. You'll be able to do that and you'll get a false sense of security that, well, actually, I know it's 3 o'clock in the morning, I know I've been awake for 16 plus hours, but gee whiz, I seem to be handling this job okay. What you've got to be aware of is you won't realise how your judgment and decision making has been eroded. Now, if everything goes to plan, you may get away with it, but it's when things change and you've got to start making decisions and you've got to make judgments around what you're doing, that's when you're going to enter into a danger zone. And that's where ideally you need to have a support pattern where there's other people that can help you get through that. And good risk controls like appropriate use of caffeine and other layers of inspection to basically risk mitigate. We've got a lot of studies that make reference to blood alcohol content. And we know for a fact that, you know, when you're getting up to the 17 plus hours of continuous time awake, that can equate to performance equivalent to blood alcohol content of 0.05. If there's nothing else I remember, particularly as a supervisor, any time someone comes to me and I'm having a discussion that's along the lines of, boss, I just need to extend the shift, I'm good to go. That sounds pretty positive, doesn't it? Take that same comment and then perceive your reaction if they rang you up and said, boss, I'm just a little bit drunk, but I want to continue with the task. Because every time as a supervisor, you're potentially having the thought of a shift extension and it's getting up into that 17 plus hours of continuous time awake for the people working on a task. That's what you should be thinking about.
Fatigue is a shared responsibility, shared between the organisation and the individuals. So from an organisational perspective, they need to make sure they're providing a safe and fair roster and making sure they're allowing people adequate time to gain rest and also adequate time to do all the normal social things of life as well, and having some sort of certainty about their roster so they can do some planning. From an individual basis, they need to make sure that they take that opportunity to rest. There are really three main causes of decreased performance in relation to fatigue. Number one is, what time of day is it? Number two is, how long has it been since you've slept? And number three, have you built up a sleep debt over the previous day? So have you missed out on some sleep that you should have had? Most people have an average requirement of about 8 hours. And if you only have 6 hours for three nights, you've built up a sleep debt of 6 hours, and that contributes to decreased performance.
Well, the organisation needs to work very carefully with its engineers to avoid potential problems with fatigue and errors that may occur as a result. It requires close cooperation between the organisation and the engineers to make sure that everyone is recognising that fatigue is a potential problem. Strategies need to be put in place by management to ensure that workers are adequately rested, not overly taxed in the work that they're doing, particularly if it's at night. careful planning and organisation, adequate rostering and a generally supportive environment so that people feel that they can admit to being fatigued when they come to work. All those things can help manage fatigue in a maintenance environment.